Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain.
Hello, a very good day to you. My name is Sister Temitayo, and I'm here once again to share the Open Heavens Daily Devotional with you. Now, the Open Heavens Daily Devotional that I'm sharing is this one that is compiled by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. Now, if you're visiting my channel for the very first time, or if you know me personally, you may be asking, Sister Tayo, why are you sharing this particular daily devotional? Why not another one? Because we have many great Christian books in the body of Christ. Well, the reason I'm sharing this is because the Lord instructed me to do so as I prepare to enter into the year 2020. So I shared the devotional in 2020 and in 2021. And in this year, 2022, the Lord instructed me to begin to share from July to December. And all those videos from 2020, they are all loaded on my YouTube channel. My handle on YouTube is Temi Aghedo, which is right on the screen. I will encourage you to visit the channel, view the videos. And, you know, while you're on there, do subscribe. And I know the videos will bless you because the scriptures are inspired by the Spirit of God. Now, how did I get to know Pastor Adeboye? He led me to Christ in October 1997, a few years back when I was an undergraduate in the University of Lagos, Nigeria, in West Africa. Praise God. So today is December the 31st, and we give God praise. But I said, better is the end of a thing, a matter, than the beginning thereof. So we bless God for giving us the privilege to see the end of 2022, and it has been a glorious year because of the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Now, every month, Pastor will always share certain prayers with us. Sometimes it's prayers for the youth, sometimes prayers for the nation, sometimes prayer for the elders, sometimes it's prayer for marriage, so many things. Now, this month of December, how Pastor does it is that at the end of the month, he would then share prayers for the new year. So we had shared these prayers earlier so that people could start praying for 2023 earlier. Now, the prayers for this year 2023 are divided into 12, and the instruction that God has given us is that we should divide the prayers into six. So there are going to be two videos for this prayer point. Amen. So they're going to be six in part one and six in part two. So let's do the prayers for the year 2023. Prayers number 1 to 6, okay, and the prayers will be coming up on the screen so that you can have them, and they will also be in the description box. Praise God. So let us start with the scriptures. Our scripture reading for today is Isaiah 43 verses 18 to 21. Isaiah 43 verses 18 to 21, just four verses, and I'm going to be reading from the traditional King James Version, and thus goes the reading of God's word. Isaiah 43 verses 18 to 21. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The beast of the field shall honor me, the dragons and the owls, because I give waters in the wilderness and rivers in the desert to give drink to my people, my chosen. These people have I formed for myself. They shall show forth my praise. Hallelujah. It's a very, very well-known scripture. So remember not the former things, not forget the things of old. Behold, God is going to do a new thing. And what is God saying to us with this scripture? So he's saying a lot has happened in 2022. For some people, 2022 was a very bad year. It was a bad year. It's a year they don't want to remember. Meanwhile, for some people, it was a very great year, you know. And some of us made, you know, really tremendous leaps. We move forward in leaps and bounds. But some people, the story is not like that. Now, whichever way it is, God is saying to you that remember not the former things, you know. Don't remember the woes and the calamities of 2022. God is doing a new thing. And he doesn't want you to carry the baggage of 2022 into 2023. It's a new day. The Bible says his mercies are new every morning. God wants to do a new thing. So he wants to correct your mindset. 2023, by the Spirit of God, is not going to be the same as 2022. In Jesus' name. But you must change your mindset. Remember not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Weeping may have endured for a night, but God is saying that joy is coming in 2023. That's what he's saying to somebody. Behold, I will do a new thing. And now it shall spring forth. So even if you've had great successes in 2022, what God is saying to us is that the thing that he's going to do for us in 2023, if we permit him and allow him and allow our mindset to be changed and to look forward, is going to be far greater than 2022, because the glory of the latter house will always be greater than the former. God wants to do a new thing, far better. Amen. It shall spring for, say, I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. So even if it has been financially tied, behold, the Lord is going to do a new thing. Shall you not know it? Amen. So that's what God is saying. And he's going to make a way. He's going to make rivers in the desert, you know, and a highway for you. So have that mindset and just give God thanks for 2023. Thank him that he even brought us this far. You know, so let's thank God. So the first prayer point is, thank you so much, Lord, for preserving me this far in the year 2022. I'm grateful for all the times you healed me, provided for me, and protected me in this year. Now, the prayer points are going to be on the screen. So let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to say thank you for your goodness, for preserving us this far in the year 2022, for giving us the privilege and the grace to see the end of 2022. Hail and healthy, exalted, multiplied, and increased, with good health, standing in church, lifting up our hands to worship your great name. Father, we are ever grateful, Almighty God. It's not by works of righteousness, but it's by your mercy that we stand here, Almighty God. Thank you for how you healed us, Almighty God. Thank you for providing for us, for supplying all our need according to your riches in glory. Thank you for your protection. For except God watcheth over the city, the watchmen watcheth but in vain. Thank you for our children. Thank you for our family members. Thank you for our businesses and our jobs, Almighty God. Thank you because young lions may suffer lack and hunger, but because we seek the Lord, you do not allow us to lack any good thing. Thank you for your protection day and night. Thank you because, Almighty God, it is well with us. Almighty God, you took us through. And now here we are to give you glory. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the year 2022. And we thank you in advance for 2023. Thank you, Father, for January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December, and November and December. Thank you because you preserved our going out and our coming in throughout this year 2022. We are ever grateful and we give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Number two, Father, please don't let anything stop me from seeing year 2023. Let me see the new year in joy, in Jesus' name. No, you've heard stories about how some people, you know, just at that last minute, they didn't cross over. But that's not our portion in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says 1,000 will fall at our side and 10,000 at our right hand, but it will not come nigh us. Why? Because we dwell in the secret place of the Most High. So we're going to pray that, Father, please don't let anything stop me from seeing the year 2023. Let me see the new year in great joy. In Jesus' name, let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you because you are the monarch of the universe. You are the creator of the heavens and the earth. You are the all-powerful, all-seeing, all-knowing. So, Father, we call upon you in the name of Jesus that, Lord, don't let anything stop us from seeing the year 2023. You have brought us this far. You have brought us, Almighty God, out of Egypt. Father, we ask that you take us into the promised land of 2023 by the Spirit of God in the name of Jesus Christ. And let us enter with joy unspeakable and full of glory. Father, Lord, cause glad tidings of great joy to erupt in our hearts as we step into the year 2023, Almighty God. Help us to see with hope, Almighty God, for hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God has been shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen. Number three, Father, please disappoint every enemy that has determined that I will not reach my goal in 2023. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, please disappoint every enemy that has determined that I will not reach my goal in 2023. You know, there can be physical enemies. Sometimes you yourself can be the enemy of your own self. A habit can be the enemy that wants to hinder you from reaching your goal in 2023. Amen. So sometimes it's not just our village people. Amen. So, but we are praying that whatever strategy of the enemy that wants to hinder us from entering into the fullness of God in 2023, that in the name of Jesus Christ, that evil power, that evil machination be destroyed by the power of God's Spirit. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we pray that you will disappoint every enemy that has determined that we will not reach our goal in 2023, in Jesus' name. Father, Lord, we silence the voice of the enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. We silence the voice of the enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. Every voice that says that we cannot, we silence them in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, we frustrate every talking of liars in our lives, Almighty God, that wants to hinder us from entering into 2023. Any sickness, in the name of Jesus Christ, we declare that with your stripes we were healed. And we declare that we are strong in the Lord and in the power of his might, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and that we will fulfill our goals for 2023, not by power or by might, but by the Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we declare, because you are the beginning, you are also the end. You started this work. Our hands have started this work, and we also finish it by the Spirit of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we declare in Jesus' name that all our goals are accomplished in 2023 by the Spirit of God. By the Spirit of God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Number four, Father, please don't let any bad habit cross into the year 2023 with me in Jesus' name. Whatever will hinder me from moving forward in 2023, I will leave it behind in this year in Jesus' name. Every spirit of anger, laziness, prayerlessness, inability to study the word of God, not going to church, anger, bitterness, any bad habit that can hinder, that wants to cross over to follow us into the year 2023, we say no. Lot is not going with us into the promised land of 2023 in Jesus' name. Lot is not going with us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We bind every spirit of Lot in the name of Jesus Christ. This far and no further, let us be separate here in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, please don't let any bad habit cross into the year 2023 with me in Jesus' name. Whatever will hinder me from moving forward in 2023, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we leave it behind in this year 2022 and we move forward into the year 2023 in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, please, by your mercy and by your grace, don't let any bad habit cross into the year 2023 with us in the mighty name of Jesus. Every friend that is not of God, we break that relationship now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every stronghold of the enemy in our minds, we declare that it's not crossing over with us into 2023 in the mighty name of Jesus. Every lack ends today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and we go into 2023 with the fullness of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, everything that the enemy has put on us that is not of God, Father, Lord, we break it, we tear it down, and we enter into the promised land in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the promised land of 2023, in the mighty name of Jesus, we leave behind every bad habit, everything that is not of God, everything that worketh not righteousness in our lives, every form of sin that so easily besets us, we leave it behind. In 2023, we separate ourselves from it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. You know, and I remember how when the children of Israel were in the middle of the Red Sea, the Bible says that the angel of God that went before the children of Israel moved from the front to the back so that he was light to the children of Israel and darkness to the children of the Egyptians, so that the two of them did not come near each other throughout the night. And that is exactly what is going to happen to us as we enter into 2023. There will be a demarcation where the wicked cannot cross over with us into 2023 because the angel of God is standing there, hindering them from moving forward. May God trouble all our enemies in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, prayer point number five. Father, year 2023 is a declaration. Year 2023 will be far better than 2022 for me in Jesus' name. I declare that I will experience numerous breakthroughs in the new year in Jesus' mighty name. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I decree and declare that 2023 will be far better than 2022 for us in Jesus' name. We declare, Almighty God, that we will experience numerous breakthroughs in the new year in the mighty name of Jesus. For God is doing a new thing. Father, Lord, we declare that there are breakthroughs. We enter into the breakthroughs of 2023 in the mighty name of Jesus. We see with a new vision in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We thank you because 2022 will be far. The glory of the latter shall far outweigh the former in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We thank you for new opportunities, new relationships, everything new in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we know it. We see it. We lay hold on it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And we thank you because we will have cause to glorify your name and testify without ceasing in 2023. We thank you because 2023 is a year of continuous celebration for us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Number four, Please go ahead of me to make every crooked path in 2023 straight and help me to escape every trap of the enemy in the new year. In Jesus' name. Father, please go ahead of me to make every crooked path in 2023 straight. Help me escape every trap of the enemy in the new year. In Jesus' name. So, when the children of Israel were coming out of Egypt, when they had gotten into the wilderness, God said, I've sent my angel before you to prosper your way. Okay, so the angel of God went ahead of the children of Israel, destroying, said, you know, and Moses would cry and say, oh, let God arise and let his enemies be scattered and let all those that hate thee flee before thee. And after a while, he would say, oh Lord, return to thy rest, you know, to the many thousands of Israel, you know. He would say that to God. So in this year, the prayer and say, Father, please go ahead of me to make every crooked path in 2023 straight and help me escape every trap of the enemy. As long, the Bible says, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. So if you want to escape that crooked path, you need to be led by the Spirit of God, because the Lord is our shepherd. Therefore, we shall not be abated. We shall not decrease. We shall not want. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray, Almighty God, that you go ahead of us, Almighty God, into 2023. Make every crooked path straight. Make every rough road smooth. Help us escape every trap of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus Christ in the new year. You said you will lead us not into temptation, but you will deliver us from evil, because thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever and ever. Father, Lord, send your angel ahead of us to prosper our way in the name of Jesus Christ. Therefore, we are courageous. We press towards the goal of the prize of the upward call of God in 2023. Make every crooked path straight, oh God. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from evil, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we plead the blood of Jesus Christ over the new year. Father, Lord, and we thank you, because we walk in the light of your word, and therefore we will not stumble in 2023 in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father, because you have already started the work, and we give you glory and praise for 2023 in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now, the memory verse is taken from Revelation 21, verse 5. And he says that he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true and faithful. For God is making all things new. It's a new day. As God has said it, see it so. It's a new day. Paul said, forgetting those things that are behind, I reach forward to those things that are ahead. I press towards the goal of the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Press. Remember not the former things or the things of old. Behold, God is doing a new thing. Hallelujah. Now, I'll encourage you to please watch the second part, which will be prayer points 7 to 12. And God bless you. My name again is Sister Tayo, and while you're on this channel, please do subscribe. God bless you.